Welcome back to the channel, everyone. Happy Danny Day, and it's a special Danny Day. Because the Warnings Keep Me Fed album just came out, and I just finished listening to it for the first time. And I figured why not to do a review of some sort, or just talk about what I thought about the album, about the songs. Of course, we have heard already a lot of the songs from the album, but now we can enjoy the album the way it should be, especially this album, I would say, to enjoy it from like the full album experience from start to end. And first of all, I have to say, just listening to the album, there's a red line in this album. It's the whole package sort of thing. And I think this is the most, like, from the Warning albums, this is the one that really got the red line in it. All the songs are, like, connected with the sounds and I don't know, the drama, how the songs are put on the album keeps the listener interested, and just everything feels like we're talking about like a real album, in a way. Like, if I have to compare it to earlier albums, there's one thing about this album, all the songs are under 4 minutes, which was kind of surprising. There isn't really slow songs in a way on the album. It's kind of a mix, it's really heavy. The sounds are really heavy, and it's like a kind of a, the whole experience, it's like the whole package, I would say. The songs being under 4 minutes, I think it's like really easy listening. To like, if you're listening or hear it, the Warning for the first time, I would say all the songs are like, in a way, like hit songs, but none of, well, I have one favorite. I will talk about it later. Maybe you can even guess it. It's one of the new songs we haven't heard yet until this day. And what was I talking about? About the easy listening. It's just all the songs like feel like I'm talking about the full album experience. They are just connected in a way, if you know what I mean. Probably will. And like the sounds on this album, there has been like a little controversy about the production of the album. And I said it before in some reaction video that I think this is the album the girls have been wanted to do like their whole career. Like, this is it is there is a production value and effects in the singing, and you can probably figure it out, the songs being under 4 minutes. I think that is something that that comes from the production as well, but it's really tight, like, package. And the songs are really, there's nothing like how do you say, like there's nothing extra in the songs, things you don't necessarily need, like compare it to a movie and they're cutting scenes that like won't give anything to the film, and it's the same with the songs, I think, I think it's that makes it a really tight package, easy listening, and yeah, the sounds are rough. It's not like, in my opinion, like overproduced, like some people have said, and I think this and the like this is, in my opinion, this is Ale album. Like the bass is really high up, and the bass is awesome, really awesome, and it shows the influence, Muse comes to mind in many ways in the sounds especially, and how the bass is like up in the mix, and the sounds overall are like Muse kind, and I know the girls love Muse and supported Muse on a gig and so forth, and I'm like so happy for the girls, like it really feels like this is an album they have what they have wanted to do all their careers, like when I look back to myself, like a younger self who had favorite bands, and you finally got the chance to go to the studio and make something for the first time, that kind of a music that you wanted to play or record all your life. Sorry. It really feels on this album. I would say that they're like back in the day when we listened to LPs, there was a first and second half on the album. And I would say in this, if you have a chance to buy or listen to this album, I would suggest that you will listen to the LP, because it really has this kind of a two-part thing, like A and B. The second part of the album is, it's way more heavier, and the songs are way more heavier than in the first half. And there was this one song that really like got my ear, and that is Sharks. Holy shit, really got me off guard. Like I was so focused on the first half of the album, and then the Sharks came out, and Paul's singing comes out, and it's something that I figure that we're going to hopefully hear in the future as well, like something like that sort of thing, the industrial rough heavy metal, I would say, also like unbelievable song, and really, if you haven't heard it, no, don't go listen to it now if you haven't, but listen to the full album. It really like hits you in the face when you least expect it, like I think it was after Burnout. Yeah, awesome song, definitely my favorite song from the album, and Yeah, there was this being a full like package album. I kind of miss the acoustic take on the song. Like in previous albums, there have been well, like more like acoustic things on the albums, and only time I heard an acoustic guitar on this this album, I think it was Escapism, and only a little part there, but yeah, it makes me like wishing more, but I understand why there isn't, because I think that there were going to the full package thing, and the red line is there. If there were to be like an acoustic song on this album, it wouldn't fit to the red line or into the drama of the album. So a little tease maybe. Like I always talk about the acoustic warning album, and I'm hoping we're going to get it at some point. Like we have heard all the radio shows where they do the acoustic versions, even from like songs like More and so forth on the radio, and awesome versions what I've heard, and that's the thing, like these songs are in a way like you don't, when you're listening to these new songs, it's not like you would think that this would work with acoustic versions, but I already know, or we already know, that they will learn or work on acoustic versions. So I'm really excited about the future, about that, and the and where this is going from this point. Hopefully the shark thing, the sounds, the aggressiveness, and who knows, even maybe even a progressive thing, progressive songs in the future as well. This is a really like really straightforward album, in my opinion. It's not an how to put this. I wouldn't call this like an well, it is a masterpiece in a way, but there's always room for more, and it kind of feels like a start of something new, and kind of a like a learning experience for something. Well, I'm sure the girls know already what the future holds, for the band sound, and what kind of a songs. I'm sure they have already written a whole lot of the upcoming like songs, and I'm really like always when the Warning publishes something new, I'm always like thinking that what's the next thing, where can they go from now, like they have achieved so much, and like their dreams coming true, and it's just unbelievable and phenomenal, like band and their career is phenomenal in this point already. Is this the fourth album, like a full album? Holy shit. Maybe I could swear on this video as well, but holy shit is the thing. And yeah, I don't know what the future holds, but I'm really, really, like, positively, waiting, and I'm sure they will provide, like always. There is no, like, there is no bad songs on this album. There is no bad songs on the previous albums. And I don't know if I have ever heard a bad song from The Warning. There's different kind of songs, and like it's so nice to see, like, when you go back to the older albums and you have listened and seen how the girls grow, becoming professionals, and this is they're showing on this album. I don't know how to translate my mind. I'm all smile right now, and what can I say? Go listen to this album, and can't wait for the music videos as well. I think there is one coming out later today, 6 feet deep, which is a banger as well. Like, what a way to start the album, with the 6 feet under, 6 feet deep, I mean. And yeah, looking forward to that. And yeah, although I have so much, I'm so behind from the schedule because I lost the computer and everything on it. So hopefully I can manage to get on the road again with you guys. And yeah, I don't know, excellent album. I leave the, if you're new to The Warning and to The Warning Army, I will leave the links down below to the Spotify links for the Keep Me Fed album, and a link to The Warning's YouTube page as well. So go check it out. And yeah, I think that is it. And yeah, sharks up, and I will see you on the next one. Happy Danny Day, happy weekend, enjoy the album, enjoy the weekend, and yeah, good old times. So take care, bye bye then.